trained very elegant has stormed home to win the $1.5 million Tancred Stakes at Rosehill Gardens. With James McDonald on board, the four-year-old mare turned it on in the closing stages.
Oh, what a mighty performance by Very Elegant. She won the Vinery last year. A cheeky, cheeky peep by James McDonald and a well-earned pat down the neck.
In the Group 1 for three-year-olds, the Gay Waterhouse trained Shout the Bar held on to win the Vinery Stud Stakes from Probabile.
Mile at Bendigo for a second year running. He did it on board nine-year-old Warrior Hell of a Street, capping a dominant display for trainer Paddy Payne.
Kicks away again, Hell of a Street. It's been a big performance up near the lead, and Hell of a Street led all the way.
Those trackside, though, found a bit of irony in the last race with Big Night Out getting the win. And while staff were taking no risks at Rosehill in Sydney, the same couldn't be said for jockey James McDonald aboard Very Elegant, the Chris Waller-trained four-year-old, claiming an emphatic four-length win in the Tancred Stakes.
Oh, what a mighty performance by Very Elegant. She won the Vinery last year. A cheeky, cheeky peep by James McDonald and a well-earned pat down the neck.
Waller hinting a Melbourne Cup run is now high on his agenda.
20. Four-year-old mare, Very Elegant, powered away from a high-class field to win the $1.5 million Tancred Stakes.
Could this be Chris Waller's ticket to Melbourne Cup glory?
Oh, what a mighty performance by Very Elegant. A cheeky, cheeky peep by James McDonald and a well-earned pat down the neck.
James McDonald producing a patient but perfect ride. Waller's 109th Group 1 victory has him dreaming of bigger things with Very Elegant this spring.
I guess Caulfield Cup would be high on our radar and even a Melbourne Cup. So let's hope we get weighted as well as some of the other horses from around the world.
Earlier, the Kiwi trainer got in some last-minute track work of his own as those arriving at Rosehill were met with a sign of the times. Bars might be closed across Australia, but that wasn't an omen for Gay Waterhouse in the Vinery Stud Stakes.
Shout the Bar in front from Probabile and Nudge. Shout the Bar goes on to win the Vinery.
Jockey Adam Hieronymus saluting for his first Group 1 win. Waterhouse and Adrian Bott with their third in as many weekends.
To continue riding on for her and get my first Group 1 winner, it's a huge thrill.
While in Bendigo, the Paddy Payne trained Hell of a Street led the Golden Mile from start to finish.
Waited for what turned out to be a negative COVID-19 test for jockey Mark Zara. Catherine Murphy reports.
It's the sole sports survivor of COVID-19.
Set now, gates are back and they're off. And
but things have changed. Trackside fashion has a new accessory.
Okay, we've got the rubber gloves and we're all sorted.
With no one watching from the stands, it's not just the horses enjoying a gallop. Some made the most of the wide open spaces.
Chris Waller and Charlie Duckworth going about their normal Saturday morning preparation.
And presenters are attempting to provide broadcast quality commentary from home. Unfortunately, no one told Bruce McAvaney's dog.
I'm not surprised about Finchie, that's for a start. And there's Frankie, she's off. So.
Strict health checks were put in place as the industry desperately tries to stay alive during the crisis.
It's not a contact sport. I mean, some people might say, well, the jockeys are very close to one another at the barrier, but generally speaking, there is a distance.
The care of a horse naturally create social distancing. You don't crowd around a horse when you are caring for it.
This week's temporary shutdown while waiting on jockey Mark Zara's test for coronavirus was a grim reminder that racing is just one confirmed case away from cancellation.
We know we're hanging by a bit of a thread, we understand that.
But shutdown or not, horses still need to be cared for.
We couldn't just turn off anyway. We can't just simply ignore the horse.
The industry is determined to find a way to persist, even if further community restrictions are imposed.
We have a huge array of quite draconian protocols now in place to ensure separation and to hit those biosecurity requirements.
Today, Zara was back in the saddle in Bendigo, putting his mount masseuse to the test. After a week where his negative test was the best news of all. Catherine Murphy, ABC News, Melbourne.